Good day, everyone. Time for weather news with J7409, the name you know, the news you can use. I hope everybody had a great Sunday yesterday. Right now, of course, what we're looking at is the severe weather map. Where could these outbreaks of severe thunderstorms with the possibility of tornadoes break out today? All right, we see the yellow. This is the severe thunderstorm possibility areas all the way from Georgia, South Carolina, Eastern Tennessee, most of my state, North Carolina. I'm not in it, though. It just escapes me on this map, and portions of Southern Virginia. Then, of course, Mississippi and Alabama. We have many watches and warnings out today. You can see how the map is. Right now, I'm just concentrating on the severe thunderstorm activity. The greatest chance of tornadoes that could happen today from these storms, as it looks now, is going to be in Mississippi and Alabama. Everybody else, severe thunderstorms. Don't get me wrong, these storms could change. None of this is wrote in stone, but the way it looks right now, Mississippi and Alabama, the areas right in here, these are the areas that could have the greatest possibility of a tornado to develop. All of these storms are going to have high severe winds and large hail. It doesn't matter. Any of these states that are that do receive severe thunderstorms today, you're going to get this. So please be aware of your sky conditions. Please be safe. If you see the sky starting to change, go ahead and take cover. This warning is out of date right now, but I'm just putting this up here to show you that early this morning, there was a tornado already started. They've already started. And this, of course, was early around 6 a.m. It was a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado. And it was located over Susan Moore, 7 miles east of Bluntsville, moving northeast at 35. The hazard, tornado. And the radar did indicate rotation. So, folks, please, please, please be aware where I just showed you where these severe thunderstorms are and where tornadoes, I think, probably have the best chance of breaking out today because they have already started in that area that I showed you. Quick peek at the watches and warnings for today as of this morning. And it will continue right on. Some of the places will change, but I will keep up with it for you. But look out. Okay, we got high winds in Texas, parts of New Mexico right down in here. You folks need to be aware of the high wind. Also down in Arizona, high wind, California, Nevada. This high wind is going to continue as we move along today. And also this morning in the panhandle of Texas, we have a severe thunderstorm warning going on. And you can see that little red dot right there in Alabama. It's just south of Huntsville. That's where the tornado was spotted earlier today. Now, snow, snow, snow. We check it out. We got snow that could happen over in Wyoming, South Dakota, also in Nebraska, these areas, and yes, down in Minnesota. So let's check that out. Okay, I'm checking on the portions of Minnesota right now, but it goes for all the other states that I showed you also. Folks, we got snow coming. Blizzard conditions are possible. Total snow accumulations of at least 8 inches and ice accumulations of a light glaze is possible. The winds could gust up to 40 miles per hour. This is in portions of central, south central, southwest, and west central Minnesota. And it probably will be extended. It's right on the verge of getting to St. Paul as it looks like now. Before it's over St. Paul, you will be included in this also. From Wednesday evening through Friday afternoon, you've got time to go ahead and prepare. Once again, you could get snow totals up to 8 inches, 40 mile per hour winds, and a light glaze of ice is possible. Once again, portions of central, south central, southwest, and west central Minnesota, you're under this watch until from Wednesday evening through Friday afternoon. And it is coming, folks, so please go ahead and prepare. Now, for portions of Maine, southern Franklin County, northern Franklin, central Somerset, and southern Somerset counties, you are under a winter storm warning. It's in effect, and it's not going to go out until midnight tonight. Heavy snow, snow accumulations of 6 to 10 inches, that's what's going on for you guys. So please be careful, please be safe, and please be prepared. For other portions of Maine, and I'll go back to the map and show you in a moment, I was just letting you know where the winter storm, one section of it was. Everybody that's in pink, when I go back to the map, that's what you can expect going on, 7 to 8 inches of snow. Now where the blue is on the map on Maine, well, you guys can expect 2 to 5 inches with some ice accumulations of a light glaze. Now, you're under a winter weather advisory that's in effect now. From 9 a.m. this morning till 8 p.m. this evening, portions of south central and southwest Maine and other areas which I will show you. So snow just about everywhere in Maine, whether it be a little or whether it be a lot. Once again, up for Maine where it's blue, 2 to 5 inches of snow, and where it's in the pink, 7 to 8 inches of snow. And, of course, we have, I've told you what's going to happen over here in southern Minnesota. Same goes for South Dakota, parts of Wyoming, and northern Nebraska, right up here in the North Platte area. We do want to check out some of these high winds right quick before we move along. We will check out what's going on over here in New Mexico now. This is a high wind watch. But it will be a warning by Wednesday, and Wednesday is when it should come through. Now, this high wind watch is in effect from Wednesday morning through Wednesday evening, okay? Now, the winds in the mountains west to the southwest, 40 to 65 miles per hour with gusts of 70 to 85. That's hurricane wind, folks. Don't mess with it. In the plains area, southwest winds 35 to 50 miles per hour with gusts of 60 to 70 miles per hour. Please, if you're in these areas, don't try to get out and drive in it, especially if you're driving a high-profile vehicle. So the winds are on the way. Please be aware. Now, this is the NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. It's pretty accurate, people. It's what it should be for the next 3.5 days. 3.5 days. This is what the weather should be like. You can see all the snow up in Canada for all my Canadian friends. Hi, Rhea. How you doing, Daryl? Daryl's over here on this coast, I believe. But we have snow up here. Then we have some freezing rain and ice, that ice that I've been talking about. You can see down in Mississippi and Alabama this morning early, these storms are here. We're going to click it on through and see how these things develop. Once we get through today and tonight, so far as the severe thunderstorm activity goes, hopefully it will die out some and just go on away, because that low is not going to develop down here. It's going to go away and dissipate, as you can see. Now, moving on along, you see the snow that's coming in for Maine, right up in this area here, as I was talking about. We'll move it on through right quick. You can see the time stamp up at the left-hand top there. We got some ice in this as well. Now, this low that starts out here, over here in Nebraska, it should develop to be a bigger system. But as it's looking right now, the isobars are not tightly compact. Now, there could be some severe weather right up in here where the warm line meets the cold line, okay? We see where the freezing rain is, but we do have that chance of some severe weather probably by Thursday up into Nebraska. So be aware of that. Also, as we move on along, you can see those isobars. They try to tighten up some. They do some. It's going to bring a lot of wind, snow. That's why some of you guys are going to have blizzard conditions up in these areas. So this is something you need to be aware of. go ahead and prepare for. And that's a check of the weather today. Be safe. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. I love you all. I'll be around for the most part. I do have some errands to run. But if anything severe, really severe, breaks out, way out of control like it did on Saturday, I'll be sure and come on live and try to keep you guys up to date. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Love you bunches. Thanks for watching.